no more comes up, what does Muhammad Ali say? Why should they ask me to put on a uniform and go 10,000 miles from home and drop bombs and bullets on brown people in Vietnam while so-called Negro people in Louisville are treated like dogs? This man gave up money, fame, went to prison, all because he did not believe. He was a conscientious objector. And I know you guys talked about this in your class. He was a conscientious objector of the Vietnam War and refused to fight for the United States. He was saying, what? These Viet, as they said, these Viet Cong did nothing to me. Why am I going to kill them? My people are here getting killed. And there's a big issue that happened in the Black Power Movement as well. You're like, wait a second. Why am I going to fight and kill people that look like me or are treated like me in another country for a government that killed my people and myself in my own home? Why? Doesn't make any sense. And if you look at the Vietnam War, this is another class for another day, it was predominantly poor black people that fought in the U.S., people that did not have a choice. When you look at drafts, people who went to universities, they were exempt from the draft. If you had money, you were exempt. You could fight for the National Guard. You could pull a George Bush. You're not going to just be the National Guard and the Army, blah, blah, blah. But black people didn't get a dime. They were killed. Muhammad Ali was one of the biggest figures. On the right-hand side, anybody ever seen this picture? This is a pretty famous picture if you watch sports. And who are these two people? Close. I'm going to talk about Jesse Owens, too. Jesse Owens, 1936. Guess where Jesse was, right? American black athlete, Ford Usain Bolt, he was the leader. Anyways, one of the big comments that Jesse Owens had, when people were like, oh, Hitler's not going to shake your hand, because he disproved the 1936 World Olympics, he disproved this whole thing about the Aryan race, physical supremacy, whatever the hell they called it. And he went out there and won 5 gold medals, setting world records before. Or was it 4 gold medals or whatever? Anyways, he destroyed it. And Hitler wouldn't shake his hand. But he was like, so what? My own American president won't shake my hand. I don't care. What's the big deal? Is that another act? You look at sports. 1968. Tommy Smith and, Calvin Smith and Tommy. Tommy Smith and John Carlos. Tommy Smith is the tall dude, the right hand, John Carlos on the left hand side, conservative. And funny enough, nobody thought he was a white dude, but he was an Australian. He was also involved in it, and he was reprimanded by his association, the Olympic Association. Because he knew what was going on. He wasn't that complicit to what was going on. He's like, you know what? I know, and I believe, and I stand with you guys. What happened was, these are guys that won the 200-meter final. You know, they're supposed to come back, fame and glory. Nope. They're kicked out in the village, came back, FBI destroyed their lives, couldn't get jobs. One simple act of defiance, came out of love. Funny enough, the guy here that came third, Carlos, he forgot his pair of gloves. So Tom was like, hey, you know, you can have my left hand one. And they put it together. And this one act literally destroyed both of their lives.